See, as a Bogan, you can't say shit, man. People immediately think that you're like, you know, trying to do something. You can't. And I need to change my voice or my face or my look. I shouldn't have wore a flannel. That didn't help at all. That's what we wear here. Hicks wear those as well. Hey, yeah, nice. I want a cowboy hat. You look like you should have a cowboy hat, to be honest, dude. Are you from Texas?
A little north up there, Toronto.
I don't know what that is. Oh, you're not even from America? Yeah, Australia, we don't give a fuck, dude, to be honest. We couldn't care less. You're all the same to us. Oh, you're Canadians.
Yeah.
See, you're in this shit too.
Oh, yeah.
Not going well for you, hey.
Not well.
That sucks. You can't talk about your politics either. White on white racism, that's, hey?
Nothing, there's nothing to talk about.
There's nothing to talk about? It's over.
Boredom. It's just boring, boring.
Yeah.
Boredom.
Is that what only people talk to you about?
Politics? Like,
yeah, yeah, at the moment?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, I'll stop then.
No, really, the weather.
Yeah.
Oh, Canada, oh, it's so cold.
Yeah. We do talk about it.
The north.
Yeah.
I live in a place called Perth now, so I mentioned that before, but I actually live in a place called Fremantle. You ever heard of it?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's like the hippie capital of Australia. It used to be Byron Bay before they sold out. It is fucking Fremantle, dude. The amount of one speed bikes I see every day. This is, like, when I moved there, it was hilarious because this is what happened on the first day I was there. A lot of vegans as well, right? And I was there on my first day eating a burger and this lady just hit it out of my hand. She's like, hey! Don't you know that McDonald's supports the torturing and suffering of animals? I was like, whoa. And why do you work here? And why in the drive-thru, ma'am? Shouldn't you go to the McCafe, serve almond milk to your own people? Get the fuck out of here. That's vegans for you. They'll get right up in your face, hey? But I haven't lived. I've been there 8 years now. I haven't left because for a Bogan person, to live in Fremantle is the most hilarious thing in the world. Although I have made zero friends, which is hard. I keep trying to talk to them, man. I keep trying to talk to these new age spiritual people. But all they say back to me is like, oh, Tim, do some yoga. Have you got a problem, Tim? Do some yoga. I'm like, all right, well, it's chlamydia, but I'll try to stretch it out. Hey, like, too close, bro? I didn't make this stage. I'm sorry, you're at crutch level. You ever had chlamydia? Not a good question for a first day, brother. I'm sorry. I only remember that after the question. My bad. We should be on your side, dude. I hope you fucking marry her. That would be sick. Trying to bring it back. Fremantle's hilarious, dude. And I do enjoy it. Have you guys done yoga? Younger people tried it? Indian person grew up on it? I don't know. That was just a straight out fucking bullshit thing to say. Maybe that's funny. Do you find it funny that Australian people do yoga and claim it for themselves? Is that? Yeah, that's so weird. In Fremantle, they do it in the streets, like as they're walking around. It's absolutely nuts. But I didn't want to be an asshole. Like, I didn't want to just be like, oh, I'm not going to do what you do here. So I tried a yoga class. And as a Bogan, that was insane. It was because they kept telling me that yoga's awesome. Not one person told me I had to do the whole class with my eyes closed, which is hard enough already. Like, difficult. But they don't even label the moves. They're not like, stick your legs out or put your arms up or anything that I know about. They're like, what are they? The downward dog? Eagle's resting nest? The fuck is that? Happy baby? I don't know what the fuck a happy baby is, but I latched onto that lady's nipple like I was fresh out. Hey, I was like, oh, this is my fault, is it? This lady's been hitting a wind chime for 20 minutes and I'm the arsehole, am I? Are you vegan? This milk has no flavour. Fuck yeah, got one of the comics at the back of the room. That's sick. That's what I flew all the way from Perth for. Thank you very much. Appreciate that, William. Do you know that new spiritual people don't give refunds? Did you know that? That's what happened. She kicked me out, the lady. Which is fair, totally, absolutely fair. But the problem is that I was a little bit nervous about the situation, so this is absolutely true. I tried to go up to her and apologize. And for a Bogan person, the way that you apologize is you shake someone's hand, look them in the eye, and you say sorry. But she's a new spiritual person, so they do all kinds of crazy shit, dude. So I'm like trying to shake her hand, and then she came in for some weird hug thing, which freaked me out. There's no way I'm doing that. And she's trying to hug me and I'm trying to shake her hand, and I just grabbed her right in the pussy, eh? Just fucking namaste. Happy spirituality. You can see why I do this job. But this is the point, dude. Like, I'm not a political person. I don't like politics. Couldn't care less. I'm too dumb for that shit. I don't like Donald Trump, but I understand that possibly somehow at some point that's a mistake. So I'm backing him up. Pussy grabbing joke, right? For Americans, isn't that? That's very good. All right. I got to get out of here. They're going to let me go. You guys have been really, really awesome. I appreciate your time. I'm sorry for my voice. It sounds even worse on this microphone. This is what I think about yoga in the end. Right, like, because you know they've got the pants. I don't like the pants, the stretch of those pants. Since when is the stretch of your pant more important than concealing your genitals? I didn't understand. And I think that's fine in the streets, like, who gives a shit? But like, in yoga, we are far too close for the stretch of that kind of pant. And then I was like, oh, okay, yeah, I get it. That's why the teacher's telling you to close your eyes. Like, it's not to reach some kind of like inner peace. It's like, so you don't see other people's inner peace. Through their buttholes, 3 feet from your face. All right, you guys have a good night. I'm going to bring on the last act. I hope you have a good time. Get back out there into the world, live your lives. Please welcome to the stage with a big round of applause, William Wang.